Oh, here we go then. Press start. I didn't press start, I pressed enter. Press tab. I did press that. It's an Isaac run. Let's see how far we're going before we get excited about this, but I'm kind of excited about it. We are going to have to beat... I will take this. Blue baby? Isaac. We have to beat Isaac. I don't think there's a way of getting past the Isaac fight. Come on now. To get to the chest, but we might be able to get to the dark room. If we're lucky, we can probably... Well, the only way of doing this is to find a self-sacrifice room on the cathedral. Which will get us to the dark room, but we can't do the chest. But the dark room's basically the chest, it's just that the first room's shit. Because it's got, you know, red chest in it. This isn't an XL floor, no. So, we can get hit. I don't want to. But we can. We have 5 cents, which could give us an arcade on the next floor as well. Probably something we might want to actually try out to quite some extent. It could give us a decent legway in this the daily run. There's a spirit heart here, which I will not take until the end because I'm not feeling too confident with myself right now. I know it's probably a bad idea to go into a game like Isaac, which involves a lot of concentration and very dodgy dodges when you're not feeling 100% confident with your ability, but I'm never feeling 100% confident with my ability in Isaac because I'm bad at the game. So I'm going to take the Spirit Heart. Now, the reason we want to keep the Spirit Heart is on the next floor. Not taking Red Heart damage will guarantee us a deal with the devil. Let's use this. Look up. Fine with that. And in doing so, we basically want to get a deal with the devil. If we take the Spirit Heart, then we have much more protection of our red hearts than we would if we didn't take it, and of course, if we took it early, we might lose it before we get to the next floor. That's Isaac 101 right there. Always protect your red hearts from the second floor, especially if you want to deal with devil. Now this chat will also give us a spirit heart for being the blue version of famine. Now I'm not sure if I want to take the orbital that it'll give us, but I suspect probably I just simply do. It's rare that you would want to re-roll what famine gives you. Ooh, that was close. Especially now I think about it, because we took the Nord leaf there. That will mean that we're invulnerable as long as we stand still for a couple of seconds. And then if enemies walk into us and get beaten up by our cube of meat here, then that's actually going to be very useful. We'll finish this floor. We have got... Now, I was going to say, we have got 6 cents. We could buy something from the shop. But at the same time, we also have the 2 of spades, so we could double our keys at any point. So we keep our keys. We can probably get a little bit better play out of it. And I was hoping for a bomb. I don't want to buy a bomb. I think it's more valuable to have the arcade chance on the next floor. Arcade Blood Machine does not count as red heart damage. If it deals with the devil purposes anyway, it hurts. It counts as red heart damage for purposes of not being hit. not dying, basically. Ah, now, mob boss trap room. Not mob boss trap room, just a boss trap room. But I started saying mob trap room, which was wrong. Good. That means we want to have only one red heart, or we can't get in there. Sure, why don't you help me out with some coins? Thank you. Of course, the one that I can get to has no coins in it. This is a decent item. Could we go in here afterwards? So this is where we just stop moving. And then all our orbitals will do all the damage for us. Perfect. Thank you.
Christy.
Cool. I haven't re-rolled anything yet, which is basically the strength of Isaac, is you get to re-roll stuff. I'm wondering whether maybe having done so would have been a great idea. Or maybe not having done so was a great idea. And I just got rescued from 2 shots by 1 orbital. So that's why we take those. These things aren't going to walk into me, so I don't really want to stand still and wait. We do get points for going fast. Find the boss. Get our deal with the devil. Yeah, we opened this. Ah. I think that was worthwhile because we did get a key back. And it's an easy enough boss fight, especially if it blows itself up. Which it may well do. This second orbital, this red fly, is actually super good because it orbits a little bit further away than the cube of meat. But it does, if not an equivalent amount of damage, at least a significant amount of damage, especially when the enemy's in an awkward place and doesn't deal with it. What we do here is we go in here and we see what there is. There is nothing of value. Let's see if there's an item in one of these chests. No. Bombs, spiders, spirit hearts are fine. That's unfortunate. We take this anyway. The play there is to go in there, see if you want to sell your HP. If you then sell your HP in a convincingly correct way, you pick up the halo and get some back. Oh, another 5 cents. Thank you. Shoot the fires for no real reason. Our two of spades will stick with us until I deem it relatively useful to use it. We'll go to our curse room now. There's probably a secret room there, but we've only got one bomb. Two more spirit hearts is fine. I didn't think this through. I want the money. Okay. We can't get in there. There is no arcade. This is a tiny floor, actually. We can't get in there despite the fact there's obviously a secret room here. There is not a secret room there. My mind is blown. That's it. I'm out. I want to play the game anymore. I'm going to go to the shop then. Give me something to use this damn... Yeah, we'll take Spider-Man. I like Spider-Man. Finally re-rolled something to our advantage. Yeah, we're going pretty... Well, not going that fast, actually. I thought we were going fast. We ain't going fast. We're going faster than the clock. But we need to do both... Oh, we've got to do Hush. That's going to be as boring as sin. The Halo is a damage upgrade as well, so... We at least get the benefit of going a little bit faster now. It's an all-stats upgrade. I would like to go even more a little bit faster, if entirely possible. Our orbitals are certainly going to help with this, but I don't want to play that game where we just stand still for ages. It doesn't seem like a good idea. I don't think there's any way of getting into that boss trap room on the previous floor at all. So we shouldn't worry too much about it. Also, we are on easy mode, not hard mode, well, normal mode, for this whole run. Obviously, that's why I got hit. Because this is easy mode. This is Flooded Cave. So that's actually going to be a harder version of this floor. But I mean, it means there's a lot fewer champions causing me grief. Which means we'll go a little bit faster than we normally would. Because non-champions have less HP than champions usually. And they do half as much damage. I kind of just want to use my orbitals for everything right now. It's a terrible, terrible idea. Defense and offense, apparently. I can't keep my brain around all these things. Here we go. Right. Trying to use my orbitals and not get hit and avoid the baddies and... What have you done? You've tinified it. Does that mean I can squish it? Yes. Ooh. A trinket. We could definitely re-roll that thing as well because it's a piece of shit. Now we can get into the shop for free. Probably don't want the spirit heart. We've got plenty of HP. Exploded tears is not worth giving up the D6 for, because the D6 could turn many shit things into many... Oh, help! Good things. Don't really fancy this game either. Blow that up. How are you not dead? How did you... You got me. Let's re-roll this. It is... okay. We might want to re-roll it again. We'll see what the boss gives us. If we get maybe a battery charge or something, that's also an option. Yarrow rune. I'll keep hold of it. We haven't really made a good play of our two of spades yet, so maybe we think about doing that. No battery charge yet. I'm going to keep going until we recharge our D6. So that I can use it on the shit that I don't want from the boss, rather than... What is this? Look at this shit. Running away from me. Shooting random shots at me. So if we recharge the D6, we get a reroll on the boss item. If the boss item turns out to suck, then we're quids in. Going so slowly. I want to beat these rooms a little bit faster, but also I want to get a recharge. Double gluttony. It says super gluttony, but in fact it's just two gluttony. So I guess that's a blessing in disguise, maybe? Ow. HP and a battery charge, so let's go. Good, good, good. Which is lucky, because that was the last room. Okie dokie. Don't really want to buy anything from the shop. So I'm going to not and say we did. We could open that chest. I don't really want to. It's all the same to you. Headless Horseman. This game is not really giving me much of a benefit right now. Give me all the hardest bosses. well, not all the hardest bosses, but it's not giving the easiest of bosses, that's for sure. But you can get this thing to explode itself. Ah! I can't dodge because you're putting so much creep on the ground. Kill it with that. There we go. That's how to use all our HP. Creep everywhere. Leave me alone. Got a pill. Probably from a mushroom that it exploded itself. Come on. We're so slow, we might not even make boss rush. Obviously, we knew we were going to get that. We'll eat the pill. Let's eat the pill. Friends till the end. It's okay. At least we know about it. Hematemesis is going to get us into a boss trap room. There isn't one. No, I think we'll keep this. And this is the devil. I'm going to take the Yara rune in spite of the fact we could have got two keys by going back for the other rune. I don't the card. I don't care. It's two keys. It's unlikely to make a difference. It may make a difference, and then I'll be salty that I didn't take it. But our rerolls have not been that great for us. I didn't even take Robo Baby. That was a mistake. Kind of forgot about it, but I want to go a little bit faster than I have been. Which is not as easy as it looks, because obviously these enemies are failing to die in a timely fashion, which is their single purpose on this earth. HP, no. Dodge around these motherfuckers. At least you don't have to wait for these bastards to pop up before you can hurt them. Ooh, careful. I hate these flies though. Leave me alone. Get rid of them. Spider mod scared the crap out of me. Thought I was being attacked by alien beasts from another alien. Alien robot spiders, no less. Yeah, we'll save that for now. We're certainly going to get a reroll before we actually find our item room anyway. I'm really trying not to use my orbitals too much because it's causing me to take a lot of damage, but at the same time, it's the only thing that actually does damage to other things, so it's very dangerous. It's a dangerous game. You know, it's you live by the sword, you die by the sword. Wow, okay. Why am I not taking damage? Just pretend that it's normal. Let's go find our item room, or our boss, that works too. We do have a basher charge on this floor, so if we don't like the item room, we can reroll that as well. We might get one naturally, whilst we're looking for our item room, which I do want to find. But also I'd like to, you know, oh, another one. Reroll our boss item twice. Oh, I took red heart damage, did I? Not a fan. Boss is the Fallen. Also a fairly difficult boss, it just split into two. But it will give us a devil item, an item from the devil room. It may give us a devil room as well, although I wouldn't hold out too much hope for that. Because we've taken red heart damage. But even if we don't get the actual deal with the devil, we get an item from the same pool, which we can reroll because we have. We'll take it and use. We won't use it, we'll take it so it doesn't show up again. We'll reroll it and we get Guppy. Yeah, it's a Guppy item, we'll take it. No deal with the devil, as anticipated. We'll take this. We have plenty of bombs, but we'll go the long way. Shop could also be rerolled. Don't have much money right now, but we could get some. All it would take is a nickel drop, or just a random poop with a penny in it. Sure thing. If I could hit these things whilst terrified about their very presence on the map, that would be nice. Another reroll. Where are these batteries coming from? What did I do to deserve it? Mustn't grumble. I guess we take Steam Sale. We can't take Steam Sale. Because we can't afford it. I don't know. Seems like such a weird play to try and come back there, because it's so far away from everything. Guess we reroll our ice room a couple of times if we ever find the damn thing. Chase this thing around. Get it dealt with. These things dealt with. You want to go in the same direction if you can as your orbital, so that your orbital remains basically on top of the enemy while the enemy's chasing you around. Since they're both going in the opposite direction, that does kind of help, but it also means that you're exposed reasonably often, rather than being covered from both sides all the time. Yeah, that onion is good, so now we leave. It does slow our tears down quite dramatically, so we're going to want a range upgrade to compensate. I also want to go to the curse room, but it's so far. Oh, I do want to go to the curse room. It's important. And there's red HP on the ground, and we've already squandered our deal with the devil and blah blah blah. It could give us a great upgrade. Could give us a deal with the devil. Angel. Okie dokie then. Fight the angel. This is not great. Actually hoping for a little bit more damage from our setup, to be quite honest with you. Why have I deserved an angel fetus? Was I not loyal to you all along? Kind of probably shouldn't have taken that maybe right now. I didn't really want to fight the angel, but I was interested in blowing up the fires to see if I got a spirit heart, which I did, but now that I've fought the angel and been hit by it, I've already lost the spirit heart that I got from this play anyway. This is rubbish. Why is my damage not gonna... I thought Dead Onion gave me a damage upgrade. I don't even want this. We'll re-roll it into the Bible, which I don't want, but I'll take it and put it back. Unfortunately, there's no way back in there. Fine. That was a complete waste of everything. Now that we've got the habit, this will cause us to start to recharge our item for taking damage. Maybe the Dead Onion was not a great idea after all. I don't know. Pretty sure I know where the super secret room is, but I'm not even going to go back for it. We need to get a press on. Oh, goodness. We need to get lucky and find all the right rooms. That's not a secret room, but it's such a secret room template. I do not like the fact that we have no really benefit to our tears right now. No, I don't want you. Troll bombs in my vagina. More likely than you think. Homing tears with this would be great because it would give them a tiny little amount of range, and it would mean that every time we fuck up and miss, which is all the time, give us a slightly better chance of sort of being compensated for it. It would also be great if Spider Mod would do its job and cause effects to actually befall these enemies. 1 cent. You're so kind. We can't go any faster unless we find the places we want to be. We've got to be the change you want to see in the world. That's our prerogative. Come on. Really? Taking a piss? Taking a piss. I honestly don't think we'll make it to Boss Rush, which is a shame because we could stand in Boss Rush and just win by using our orbitals and the invincibility we get from that item there, whose name I'm going to remember before I finish this sentence. The Gnawed Leaf. Ah, I see. Told you. This is a daily run as well, so I've got to do better. Thank you to my orbitals for completely protecting me from that harebrained situation. No, you do not get to fire. You do not get to fire. Very well. There is a tinted rock. I don't think I've taken damage yet. Have I taken damage yet? Maybe. Well, if I'd known it was going to be one of those, I would have blown up the... I would have got the key. In fact, I should have got the key. That was a badly placed bomb. I freely admit that was a badly placed bomb. Have I taken damage on this floor? I'm not sure. All I have in my mind is the sound of Isaac taking damage. It's such a common theme in my runs and my let's plays. Another bloody chest. Could at least contain the spirit heart, or at least give me a bomb I can access. Gotcha. Where is anything of value? Come on, we're not even on the depths. Oh, how many opportunities for spirit hearts did I squander? Not even squander. I went for them. The game was not forthcoming, and now taking red heart damage, and I'm not going to get myself another deal with the devil, which is a bit rich to complain about, really, because we got a free deal with the angel anyway. And we re-rolled it, and it was still shit. Which just feeds into my standard salt about how shit angel rooms are in the first place. I hate them. They're really bad. Well, that was expected. Oh, a range upgrade. That's exactly what I asked for, actually. So I'm not even going to re-roll it, even though it's traditionally not a very well-respected item. The range upgrade with this setup definitely helps. We could also re-roll the shop and the item room, so we haven't waited a re-roll. And I definitely shouldn't be taking all this damage. I'm trying to use my orbitals, you see, because they're the only things that actually I can control. I will take Rotten Baby, because it's great. We'll go into the shop for free. I'll re-roll it. Theirs options probably doesn't help us. I'm going to buy it anyway. I'll take the battery charge because I can. I'm going to do with this Yara rune, do you think? I'm just going to leave. I don't think we're going to get to boss rush without a miracle intervening. Miracle could intervene, so... let's see. Oika Vault. North. Bad. Please give me something I don't want so I can reroll it. In fact, stop shooting the fires and let Envy die on me. Yes, correct. I think it was probably correct to have shot the orange fire, which will shoot me back. Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted. It was a troll bomb for my troubles. Envy is such a kidder. These orbitals have saved me from so many foolish mistakes. I'm very proud of them. I nurtured them from the very start of the run, and they have grown, blossomed into saviors of all things good and holy. Well, probably not good or holy. Well, maybe one of them. I'll get in there for that. Kill this thing, I hate it. Kill this thing, I hate it. There's almost no way we can get to Mom and beat Mom. Okay, well, here's a fight in this amount of time because we're doing such poor damage that honestly, there's no way of getting into the Mom fight reasonably. What? That just went whoop. What, did he give me a fly? I don't know. Yeah, we're not going to beat Mom in 10 seconds, so there's no point crippling our future advantages for a very, very outside chance of being able to get to boss rush, which would give us some points, but honestly, I think we get more points for just not dying right now. I think we want to spend this key here. I also think we want to go all out on re-rolling this. Did we re-roll anything in here? Yes. Ah, that was a good idea. Well done, me. Doesn't get us the key, unfortunately. It doesn't re-roll the rocks with keys in. T-I-L. But now we can... we can't actually reach that. Well, I was going to use that. I can use this thing. Here we go. We could also get this pill. Big whoop. Big whoop. Cursed eye. I've already seen it. I didn't want it last time. What makes you think I want it this time? Let's try and get some benefit out of this bloody floor. See if we find a shop, maybe. Find the shop. Eat the shop. Now, normally you'd expect to maybe be able to, deflect those things with your tears, but of course our tears do not have any knockback. So that was a scary situation. But we made it through. Okay. Look at the super secret room. Look at any secret room, to be honest. We found one of them. The other one could well be opposite. No, it wouldn't be opposite, because there was a gap there. We couldn't reach that wall. So our second secret room could really be anywhere. Wow, that was close. This... come on. Let me help. What's happening? Use the sucker to your advantage. Sucker, sucker. Don't push me. Push a push pop. There is no secret room there. What are you even placing a bomb for? Man, I hate this. Can I even reach... You do have Rotten Baby to at least create flies for us. He says with a desperate laugh. Everything's fine. If I say it often enough, maybe I'll convince myself. This is what we're here for. El Shoppo. BFF is probably worth the money that we don't have. Well. We buy a key. We re-roll and see if it's worth it. Oh, it could be worth it. Let's see what's in here. Is that enough money? That is enough money. We buy this. We leave. Ta-ta. We save this key. There could be anything of value on the upcoming floors that require keys that are not the things that don't exist on the upcoming floors, i.e. shops and item rooms, but we may still get something from our key that is more valuable than just that one golden chest that's left. Let's see how long it actually does take us to kill Mom here. Yeah, walk into it. That's a good start. Why did that take a full heart of damage, by the way? Mom does not do a full heart of damage. and I had a full black heart. So, pardon me. It took us more than 20 seconds, so I'm kind of okay with that. Oh, no tinted drops for me to feel bad about not getting... It's a bad situation. It's not a bad situation. We've got plenty of HP, but we're not really giving ourselves the, you know, the future options that we need. We haven't really picked up a damage upgrade at all. And that's thanks to Angel Run. And the Angel Run was natural on this particular daily because we didn't have the option of paying for the deal with the devil because there was nothing to buy. I did forget we had Nord Leap. Don't know if standing still is the right idea. It's not like we're racing towards anything. We do have to do Hush, maybe. But I don't think it's worth it. I don't even know if we can. We can stand still and beat Hush, theoretically. But, you know, if you want to watch a 40-minute stream of standing still beating Hush with, you know, a couple of orbitals, then you probably should check your priorities. Well, there's only one person watching. Maybe there are more people watching. I can't see because I've got my own priorities in the wrong order. The wrong window is on top. Maybe we'll adjust that in a second. Died. The red fly is actually just the right distance for me to feel comfortable using it. I'm just going to click here and here. There we go. Apparently two people watching. Am I one of them? Probably. Doesn't seem to be a way of getting it to not show you your own stream while still being able to use chat. Don't need the push pin. We've already got piercing shot. We've also got spectral tears, which is actually really useful when you've got a little bit less confidence than you could have in a run, because it means you can hide behind rocks, which is very, you know, noob camper sort of thing to do, but it works. I will take the... Oh, no. I will not take the damage to go in there, because we still could get a deal with the devil. And even if we don't get a deal with the devil, we can still get a deal with the angel, and it could actually be valuable for the first time in its miserable history. First mod I make for Afterbirth Plus, he says, stealing somebody else's joke. Angel rooms would be worth something. I don't even think it's a controversial opinion to suggest that angel rooms are absolute shit. The chance of them having anything of value in them is... Oh, well, we took damage. It's mediocre at best. In fact, the chance of them having something mediocre in them is basically guaranteed. There may be three or four angel room items that are worth anything. And there are not very many angel rooms that actually contain items. Well, we took damage. I'm not going to go back to the curse room, though. It's too far away. I'm lazy. Also, it will cost us 2 full HP to go in and out of it. So if there's nothing of value in there, we're going to feel a little bit salty that we spent 2 HP. These are not secret rooms, even though they're clearly the correct place to put them. Why's my phone buzzing? What's happening? Ah! You got me. They completely penned me in. I had no idea what to do. There's no way out. What colour are you? White. It is an email. Brilliant. That's what I needed. Probably shit. Something I don't care about. Probably a PHP job in Southamptonshire or something completely irrelevant to all of my criteria for looking for jobs that I put up several years ago. Great. That was actually really good. Die. I hate these things. Not only can you not find them, you can't get near them when they do pop up. And then they shoot you from wherever the hell they are, which is further away than you can see. You get one shot in and then they're gone. Oh, there's two of them. Hello? Come on, guy. Brah. Where are you, brah? King got him. How long did that... Oh! I didn't even realise what it was. I was like, ooh, that looks pretty. Let's go and play with that. No. It's like fireworks. Not the software. I don't even remember what the software did. Finally, my instinct is correct. keep trying. It's fine. I want that. Oh, how bad can one run go? Tapeworm might be worth a bomb. And it's certainly worth replacing my current trinket with anything, really, because our current trinket doesn't matter because there's no more shops, unless we do manage to get to the hush pipe by some miracle. I don't think we're going to do too well on this run. Maybe I should have re-rolled some more? Maybe there was a 48-hour energy pill somewhere and I just didn't know about it. More HP. I will do this. That gives us much better range. It doesn't give us a better shot speed, but it gives us much better range. It's kind of what we want. We'll probably re-roll what Conquest gives us, because Conquest gives us a horsey that lets us fly. But we kind of want to keep the... Well, I tried to use my orbital, but in fact I just fucked up. And there are, well, many better things than a horsey that can let us fly. Although, IRL, no. There is no better thing than a horsey that lets you fly. Ooh. I said I don't want either of these. That's even better. Nor these. Yes. I'll take this. That's several HP. I'm still not going to go to the curse room. Still not going to go to the curse room. You can't make me. And it's gone. So, you missed out on that. I should have maybe Yared that battery charge. But you don't know, do you? You might not have needed both of your battery charges, and then you wouldn't have used the Yarrow rune. It's not that you can use the Yarrow runes on a chest. I'm not going to play the chess. So the usual Yarrow rune play is to get 8 chests instead of 4 at the start of the actual chess. I mean, it's a good thing we're not doing the chess, we don't get the keys. Hematemesis. Could get us into this mob trap room right here. This boss trap room, I mean. Which is probably worth doing. Yeah, let's do it. Hammy's head is decent. Decent enough? Maybe it is decent enough to take. I don't envisage too many things left to be a reroll target. And Tammy's head at this stage is... Well, the tears that Tammy's head produces are way better than the tears that our face produces right now. Well, always. It's just they're better tears in terms of damage. So... Maybe we take it. I think we take it. Don't really get much benefit out of it on this room, but we got it from this room, so this room's already given us its, you know, built-in benefit. And we did get to use it once, and it really made short work of Fistula, actually, so can't be too upset about that. That would be silly. I haven't got any bombs to open those, but I'm expecting some, so... And we did get 3 red HP back, and then that room remains open. We could actually Yara the other 2 chests. May not be a terrible idea. Let's do that. Let's do that. Yara. Obviously, ideally, we would have Yarrowed the one with... That's really shit. But at least we know what's in them now. Money and trinket. Ideally, we would have Yarrowed the one with Tammy's head in it and thus got... Oh, we don't need anything. Okay. Another head item, I guess. Pretty sure, anyway. Yeah, that's very much worth taking. Make short work of a lot of these things. If we stop shooting here, then our orbiters will deal with it. There we go. Probably, Guppy's head, Steven, any of these things, really. Would be valuable. So that could have been a minor misplay. Now, the only reason it would not really have worked is we didn't have any bombs. The reason bombs are important is that when we use hematemesis, we drop 3 red hearts on the ground. Had we gone back for Yarrow, we would not have been able to get back to the mob trap room without picking those HP up. And then we would have been allowed in. Excuse me? I contend that there was a... That was a pretty bad use of time to save. I contend that I got hit at all, is what I was going to say. But, you know, game knows. Half heart interval is valuable too. What? These things need to decide when they're going to fire. Fire then. Rather than, you know, just inventing a random time. Making me dodge around like a fool. Some of these enemies need a little bit more predictability to make me happy about them. Also, I hate these. Can't see him. I stood on the creep. That was definitely my fault. I will take full ownership for standing on the creep. I know the creep hurts. Is it? Yeah, creep is when you do it to yourself, you do. And that's what really hurts. That is a song. So, saying it hurts in context of creep was appropriate in a cultural situation. It wasn't just my brain inventing things. I've already taken... I haven't taken red heart damage. Ooh! He says, with more gusto than he really feels. I'll give him some. I was going to say,
the world.
Is this amazing? It is not, because even though we had Nord Leaf active, we were still taking damage. I was kind of hoping that Nord Leaf was making us immune to that damage. Oh, shit. Well, now we've got permanent Polaroid invincibility active, which means we have no HP left. This happened before, and will happen again. The wheels of history ever turn. Ever turn, ever turn. Nope, not what I meant. Ah, you fucking hit me. That was terrible. 1900. I was 32nd the other day. This game has so much variance. I died. I'm watching it happen on the screen you're about to see. Oh, no. Oh, what a shot. Look at it. Bullshit. Well, I guess I should probably go to sleep or something. You know what? Screw it. I'm going to do some more game. So I've got this extra file here. Here we go. Let's keep going. Judas? Oh, greed mode, apparently. That's right, I was doing greed mode runs. This should be brief but entertaining. Judas on greed mode is extremely hard because you only have 1 HP. So, we need to do something about it ASAP. Can't go to the curse stream yet, we can't play the demon beggar yet. We haven't got any money yet. We've got 3 cents actually, so maybe that was a little bit premature of a complaint. No more money there. But we can do really well against these waves because we have a great advantage in terms of damage. Normally at the start of the grease mode run, your major disadvantage is that you're not doing any damage. And you get overwhelmed by the waves and you have to press the button, which would cost us... It hurt us and put us in a very dire situation, but now that we are... Since we're Judas, we have Book of Belial available and start off with a decent amount of damage anyway. It means we have a lot more of an advantage to begin with. Just don't get shot. You can avoid it. Now, our damage is so good right now that basically I think we'd be okay for a majority of the game, provided we get the usual greed mode benefits, which is loads of cool items. What is this? We've got 10 seconds to beat these bastards. We're doing so much damage. You can imagine how a little bit less damage and these things would quickly become a huge problem. We're going to be producing corn flies, which I hate. Didn't even take a single hit, so I'm happy with that. Got plenty of money, which means we could buy... I think this gives us... Spirit Height, it does. I think it also gives us a Tears upgrade. I wouldn't mind buying the screw there, but we should probably chase a key and see what we get from this locked item room. We could also use this, because it's to our benefit. Oh. Since we know we're not going to buy any DPS upgrade before we run out of things to do here, it would be probably a good idea just to keep going with this Book of Belial influence that we have. Please let me out. I'm not really appreciative of these tactics that you're pulling, game. We should use the Book of Belial charge to beat the next optional wave, which gets us to deal with the devil. That was an OP jump. So now, unless the deal with the devil gives us HP, we can't take it. Shit. Book of Belial effect, besides a damage upgrade for the room, also gives us a better chance to deal with the devil, but that doesn't count doesn't matter for greed mode, it's just fairly irritating. Abaddon. No, we're not even. Bacano will use. And then we'll keep Algiers for now. And we'll go and buy a key. Just the one. We could use Algiers right here, actually. Might be a good idea. Could buy a second key. Oh, we need to buy a bomb as well. Yes. And Orbital, as we've seen, is our savior in many situations. So we buy a key. We use Algiers here. Just keep giving this thing HP that doesn't exist until he gives us a syringe or something. Please pay out before my... Oh, really bad. Do not want it. Puberty. It could have been a health... Oh. We had a chariot card as well. Unless he gave us that. I think he gave us that. Fair enough. Well, no more money on this floor. And we got puberty, which means we have a permanent character appearance change. So pleased to have picked that up. Nickel? Oh my god, nickel! Right. I'm coming back in. I'm buying this. Try and stop me. Speed upgrade would be nice, but... Tears upgrade! Our DPS should be out of control now, especially with Book of Belial going. Right. Anything that we want immediately? Yes, we want this. Thank you for providing. There's a Tinted Rock here. Which could also be good for us. And there's a D20, which means that basically this game is over. Right, what we need to do now is get 15 cents. We need to get 20 cents. Should have come in here first. That's really annoying. We buy the D20 and use it, and then we go nuts. Whoa. Oh, yeah, use this. Try not to take too much damage, 007. Do be careful, 007. Help. Don't pick... Oh, yeah, do pick up the money. You want that. Just get 15 cents. Excuse me? Where are these spiders coming from? Were they just amongst all that money and I couldn't see them? Because they were amongst all that money. That's BS. Not even BNBN, that's BSBS. This is going to be a little bit longer wave than others. I don't know. Okay. Forever Alone is actually a decent orbital for its distance. It can hit things that are quite far away from you before they become a fly in your particular point. That's 16 cents. Now we use the Book of Belial to get more money on the ground. Pardon me? I'm pretty sure that I have a little bit of grace time when this thing spawns. Don't get trapped in the corner. Seems pretty obvious that that would be a bad idea. Yeah, bring it on. Oh, didn't mean it. Oh, I stood on the button, that's why. It wasn't even the horn. I was still stood on the button. It doesn't really give you the opportunity to get off the button before it takes damage and triggers a stop. And then we use this. It's only two Larry Juniors. Not quite sure how this counts. Oh, it's a Larry Junior and a Hollow. Still, not sure how it counts as a nightmare boss round when we're this powerful. In fact, at any time, because these are extremely weak enemies. Maybe now we can take something of value. Nope. Have a chariot card. Can we do any good with that? Maybe. But we're going to buy this. And then we're going to go hog wild on this. Do we take 5 cents? 1, 2, 3. Yes, we do. If we reroll that, we buy this. We take this, this. Ooh, golden key. Yes. Do this, we reroll everything. Now we get completely balling out of control. We need money. There's no money here. In which case, we open these and hope for some. There's no money here! I'm sad now. Bad gas. Not even a bomb. Come on, game. I want to use... Want to take damage? Don't want that. Another fly item. Fair enough. Money out here. No. money in here? No. It's two tinted rocks. What's in here? Hierophant. But we don't have to make the most of this right now.
The chariot.
I feel like I kind of do. We could break our... Ooh. Let's do this. There we go. There's some money. And we got two bombs. How did we deserve those bombs? I don't know. Got one back. Very nice. Reroll. No chests. Thanks. Okay. Full health is nice to know about. Buy this. Reroll. I think we just take the stuff and go. We're going to get way more rolls on our D20 over time. I'll do this. No. No spirit hearts in there. Could open that. I don't really care to. Try the other tinted rock. Oh, try the tinted rock. The single tinted rock that remains. Got a bomb back. Okie dokie. Well, that seems fair. We'll use this bomb on the next floor if there's an opportunity. But mostly we're looking to play with the D20. If I get Crown of Light from this, I'm going to be super salty. Where's my chariot card? I think I re-rolled it. Stuff. Ooh, thank you. Fair enough. Don't mind if I do. Right, now we start making... There's no battery charge in here, but there is a re-roll machine. BFF might be worth taking, actually. What's in here? The box. That is some stuff, as it will advertise to us. What's this? Two of spades. I'll use that.
Of spades.
And then... I don't think we can re-roll this, so we just take it. Ooh, Bardenil. Barden. Now in there, but it was worth a look. Press button to start going. We do not have Book of Bilal anymore, so we're going to be a lot slower. Possibly we'll have a certain amount of a disadvantage. Possibly not. We seem to be doing okay from those two tiers upgrades that we got. And our familiars, of course. But we want to use the D20 to get a massive advantage in terms of money, which will both allow us to re-roll the everything a lot, but also allow us to buy the things that we don't need. Excuse me. Re-roll. So the first thing we want to do, apart from re-rolling like that, is try and get a battery charge in the in the shop by re-rolling the shop as many times as we need to do so. Or else, we don't really have one key ingredient of this, which is to be able to continually re-roll rather than just occasionally re-roll. I do really like Lost Flyrain, I mean Obsessed Fan right now, because everywhere I go appears to be where an enemy then decides to follow me. Super good. Excellent. Because we don't have any money, but we have got a bomb. Don't know. Let's use our bomb to re-roll everything. Is that in the right place? No. Let's use our bomb for no fucking reason. Alright, in that case we'll pick up the money. Use that to re-roll everything. Amnesia. Well, that's helpful. One re-roll and a battery charge, please. No. No battery charge. In that case we keep re-rolling, because there's no point having D20. Without a battery charge, we can't do anything with it. That's a spirit heart. I don't... Okay. Open the chests. I think we take this. Sure thing. Let me start our boss fights. We might be able to get a natural reroll from doing boss fights. Let's see. Brownie, I do not want to fight at all ever again in my whole life. Please leave me alone, you incorrigible massive turd. Literally, you are a massive turd. It's not like I was being rude just now. I hate you. What? You shot a little tiny poop at me. and it hit me. The fact that it hit me is slightly more embarrassing than the fact you tried to throw your own ship at me. Oh, hello. Look how weak they are, and yet they still got me. This is bullshit. Luckily, we have good envy control. And good jealousy control. It's part of our lifestyle. Jealousy is not one of the seven deadly sins for some reason. Actually, why is it? Why is envy a deadly sin? I assume deadly sins are, it's like a, it's almost a metaphorical overstatement of the danger of this sin. Because you can hardly call pride a deadly sin, because you're supposed to take pride in good work, you're just not supposed to be proud of it, right? Likewise, envy, wanting stuff that other people have, is not in and of itself a bad thing. If it motivates you to, you know, go off and try and get it. But at the same time, envy, most of these sins are sins in one of their guises. But then why isn't everything else that is a sin a deadly sin? Why is envy so much more deadly than jealousy? You know, envy in and of itself just causes you to be upset that people have stuff that you don't, basically. Which is fine. It's a natural emotion to feel if other people get stuff and you're like, oh, feel really salty that you managed to achieve this thing and I didn't. Why did I not get a charge for that? Please be Krampus. I'm not Krampus. However, I'll take the mark. I'll take the sacrificial dagger. And we will rejoice. We're getting plenty of keys, so if we need keys, for any reason. Of course, if we don't get a battery charge here, we just keep going until we do. There is one. Now we need 5 cents. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And a key, which I couldn't help but take. Take this. We roll this and hope for a nickel. There's no nickel. More keys. Stop it. Nickel? Did I go into either of those item rooms? I do not recall. Eternal heart will become a red heart on the next floor. Yes. I thought of re-rolling these. That's why I left them on the ground. Turns out not necessarily going to happen. That's 2 cents. Don't take this trinket, whatever you do. You'll never get rid of it again. Okey-dokey. Tammy's head. I need a coin. One coin. Any coin. There's one. Dankeschön. Yoink. Reroll. No nickels. Fine. See, the reason you want to come back in here and re-roll is that you can re-roll a chest while it's still open, but when you leave the room and come back, it's no longer still open. It's gone. So you want to take all the nickels, but nothing else, but unfortunately it's not giving me any bloody nickels when I re-roll in the first place, but we're still getting a very excellent advantage out of all of this. There's no point taking that, but I took it anyway, so whatever. Pheromones. Now that we have this infinite bomb, we can blow this up, get some money. Plenty of money, actually. Plenty of coins. Keys. Plenty of keys from the coins. We buy this, we re-roll, we go back in, we buy it again. Now we can re-roll the open chests. I didn't mean to take that. We'll take this because it does have some value. We're not going to be re-rolling Tammy's head because it doesn't re-roll items, it only re-rolls consumables. So we re-roll everything, we come in here, we buy this, we open all the things. We're basically hoping for golden chests that contain stuff. Eventually, we'll be able to buy chaos. In fact, I'm going to keep hold of... Oh, that was silly. I was going to say I'm going to keep hold of... Flat penny, thank you. Because... Then we're going to... Every time we pick up money, we create a key. Not every time, but a large proportion of the time when we pick up money, we create a key. And thereby, we basically... We want to keep the money on the ground in order to re-roll it and make more money, but eventually we have to start using the money for the money. Oh, I've done it again. Re-roll these things. There we go. I would like to take a lump of coal, but if we keep picking up like more than 5 cents and creating a bunch of keys, then we're going to keep the economy going. That actually, yeah, we'll take full health. You know, without running out of things to reroll. So now we reroll all of this. Go and get our battery charge and do it all again. Coin, 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 coin. Normally it would not be worth picking up the coins, only the nickels. We're not getting very many nickels, which is probably why it's nice to be getting so many coins. So now I have nearly enough money to buy not only the battery charge, but an item. And that's basically the goal, keep buying the items until we get items that we want. That don't suck. It appears to be easier said than done right now. Okay, justice.
Justice.
Like getting the spirit heart. That's very helpful. Of course, occasionally we're getting troll bombs and shut. But, you know, whatever. HP and luck. I don't think luck helps us. We'll take infamy because it's not going anywhere. And it's a passive item, so we get to keep it. Probably want to take the curved horn out with us. So what we're going to do is we're going to forget the fact that we had some open chests and do that instead. Curved horn is double damage while we hold it, but we don't want to re-roll it. Infested. Full health, bad gas, I don't really care about these. Just going to re-roll everything. This economy is not really popping off quite at the speed I was expecting it to. Half the time it's probably because it takes so fucking long to open all these chests and pick up the stuff and run away from the bad guys and stuff. I'll re-roll. Re-roll. I'll take blue cap. Thank you. Open. It's not like we're using up our keys because we've got the golden key, so it's infinite amount, right? Judgment. Ooh. Put your payout straight away. That would have been great. Please.
Judgment.
Plenty of red HP as well, so it's not like we're really wasting anything by doing this. Except for time. But that's why we're here. We've got nothing else to do. Death. Lay waste to all that judge you. All those around you somehow. More ice. The speedball's nice, by the way. And synth oil is also nice. So now we reroll all of this. We go and buy a thing. Still not enough money. Whole point of this is to generate money. It's not really happening. Infinite bombs. We've already got infinite bombs. Okey-dokey. Don't really understand the golden bomb thing that was introduced in Afterbirth. I mean, I understand that it mimics golden pennies, but at the same time, don't really feel like it's... It doesn't really make sense. A golden key makes some amount of sense. You can imagine a golden key would be like a skeleton key, a magical key that creates a lock. It's somehow magical. It's golden, right? Golden bomb, though. What? More HP. Buy this, because we're not going to be able to... okay. I guess we're not going to buy that. Take. Don't want swallow penny. Just take all the money and run. Take the money and run. Take the money and who's in a... It is a posy. Who's in a bunker? Women and children, first and children. First and charge. Yeah, we can't pick up any more HP unless we get more judgment cards, which I think we did, but whatever. Get a jail free. Devil. Death. What's this one? Rules.
Rules.
The walls will harden over time. Time is the essence. Wheel of Fortune. Two of Spades. Even more keys, we don't really need them. Reroll it. Fucking dumbass. We'll take this because I'm sick of HP. Yeah, just keep giving me fucking rerolls of random shit. I don't want them. Accidentally picking up keys, in case you were wondering. Thought you said, stop picking up everything except money. I did. That is not going to plan, necessarily. The world. Well, I think the world would override amnesia. If you get a card that literally tells you where everything is, it wouldn't matter if you could remember it or not. You've just been told. Two of diamonds, now we could buy everything. Great. Let's let's go and do that. Buy this. Buy the D6, which we will come in here and immediately use to reroll everything in here that we don't want. Glitter bombs and Blue Baby's only friend. We are now Beelzebub, so we can fly. We've got a Bacana room, so I'm just going to use. Come back out here. We'll take. Take this and reroll these. Fuck, that was my D20. I didn't think of that. Oh, what a noob. Oh, well, I'll take everything. I wanted BFFs before anyway. It didn't reroll the freaking shop, though. Did you notice that? Very upset right now. Take this. I will take my blank card, and to hell with you all. I don't want blank card strength. What else have we got out here? There's plenty of stuff. We might accidentally get a D20 anyway. We'll take Fate. That gives another HP. Oh, what a misplay. I thought of re-rolling the shop, you see, but it hadn't occurred to me that re-roll the stuff that's in the shop. Cricket's Head is a great damage upgrade. I mean, we've won. It's almost infeasible that we fail to beat Greed right now, especially with Blank Heart Hierophant, which is one of the best combinations of, you know, it's one of the best synergies in the game. So we'll make sure to keep it. Anything else in here that we really want? Unless we've got a Two of Diamonds in here, let's check. Yes! Alright, so screw you and your everything.
Two of diamonds.
I'm just going to keep blank card two of diamonds-ing. I should have probably done it then. Give me that back. I don't want to use the D100, even though it seems like a great idea. I want to reroll literally everything we've ever, you know, held dear. Car battery. Chaos, there we go. Now I can keep going because our car battery made sure that we have a double-double whenever we use it. Oh, this is great fun. Yeah, we'll take Mini Mush. Might as well take the HP. I'm bored of buying that one. Buy this. What? Ah, it pushed my golden chest off the edge. Keep buying HP. We're breakfasting ourselves. We've seen everything. That's it. There's nothing left in the whole game. This is why we buy this. This is why we do. This is why we play this game. This is absurd. This is literally absurd. This is as absurd as this game gets. I think you'll admit, pretty fucking absurd. I'm gonna have nothing but red HP, but it doesn't matter. Buy this. Two of diamonds. As long as we have more than 25 cents when we use the two of diamonds, we're getting back to full coins. So we can do this literally forever. I'm not going to reroll my run. I'm now a mushroom. Aren't we all? It's a blessing and a curse. I'd like to put down my blank card somewhere else and reroll what's in the shop. Can I do that? I don't think I can. And we've got the... I forgot we had the... Sure, Bob's brain. Dead cat. Now we've got no HP again. Luckily, we've breakfasted ourselves completely. What's... Oh, Crown of Light! That's what we're here for! Except... Oh, I re-rolled everything. That was not... I didn't have... How many times are you going to do that? Dude, though. Whatever. Look, this is not the run in which we're trying to get Crown of Light, because it's the wrong save file. But now I know that can happen.
Two of spades.
I'm pretty happy. Because that was Chaos. Chaos gave us that. Got Tears upgrade and some spirit. Right. We've basically won. We're a little bit worse off because we took... What did we take? Because we picked up 9 lives. Which is a guppy item, so I'm in a guppy. So we're going to be doing a lot of damage and producing a lot of flies, and everything's going to be sweet from here on out, but speed down is not what I want. Strength, sure. Full health, sure. And we'll take this. Alright. Fuck it. I screwed everything up, but it's still fine. Sensor, sure. Slows enemies down when they get closer. So we haven't seen Explosivo yet, so now we have. Perfect. 7 cent item I don't need. Another full health pill and amnesia, whatever. You have nothing on me. Don't even try. I accidentally stepped on the button. I wondered what hit me. So we're producing flies at a rate that has not been seen since some culturally appropriate time in the past where there was a lot of disease and therefore flies. We are getting through these these waves like a surfer. Just take all the money, I don't really care anymore. You are already dead. I was going to attack you with my sacrificial dagger, but instead you just died for my sins. You're going to be annoying, aren't you? Yes. See if I can get you to pop up somewhere and stab the shit out of you. Okay. So much potential for HP. And tell you what, I'm actually going to go and take this because it's extremely fast. Honest. Flight and spectral tears, brilliant. Then we've got something to buy a devil item with. You're already dead. Now you're dead. Oh, now we're dead. Which is not going to be an option. Okie dokie. Well, I guess that was that floor. That is literally it. We've done everything. I haven't used any of my BFFs powered. Familiars here. We've got Ouija board as well, which is special tiers. We've already got that. Another HP upgrade. So we've breakfasted ourselves quite considerably. Do I want cancer or curved horn? I think I've got a curved horn, actually. Don't really care too much for circle of protection. But I will take post hat. And we have achieved 3 more flies because being Beelzebub, Lord of the Flies, any flies that do show up actually turn out to be ours. They just turn into friendly flies. I guess we just re-roll a lot. We've got prize bomb. Of course we've got clear bombs, so we get an actual bomb out of the bomb. Yo, dog, I heard you like bombs. We put bombs in your bombs. Surprise. I keep accidentally turning the thing off. I don't mean to. Accidentally turning off. We are immune to explosions, so do your fucking worst. You ain't getting none of this. We're from the Brits. The world. It does not show us the only secret room, which is the super secret room. So, not too bothered by that. This wave is bullshit, but it's dead, so not that bullshit, I guess. Keep pushing the buttons. Don't really mind taking damage because it causes a fame to have a go. This seems bad, but apparently we just owned everything with sacrificial dagger anyway, so who the hell cares? I don't give a shit. I am a maverick. I am out of control. We have chaos, so our options here are bollocks. We could buy an HP upgrade for the HP that it would give us. We actually got a black heart out there, so I can't be too salty. But I'm going to be slightly salty anyway because I want to be. We're going to buy the salt. We're going to buy Death Touch. We're absolutely buying Death Touch. And we'll go. Good day to this floor. That's pretty much it. it's turned out well. Hope you've been even watching, let alone enjoying my rather ridiculous. I've got 99 keys as well, as if I need them. Guess we reroll this. I don't really care about any of this. I honestly don't really care about Guppy's paw, to be honest. So Death Touch is just a nice damage upgrade, as if we needed one. Everything is falling under our godlike wrath. And I'm actually managing to avoid running into enemies by paying attention to the direction I'm moving my character in. rather than the direction I'm firing in, which is almost never actually worth. That's the first time an explosive shot has had the opportunity to actually explode. It's a little bit of trivia there, I think. We do have a battery charge. Let's buy something that's worth. Yeah, rubber cement, that seems fun. And we're back to breakfast. We're still on breakfast. Two bombs out of that one bomb. Naturally. I assume that you can't dig down beyond the very last floor. That wouldn't make any sense at all. Ooh. I honestly think that it would be a very good idea if we managed to get Mom's box. Because that would double the effect. Pardon me? Oh, I. That would double the effect of our trinket, which is currently doubling our damage. 15, yes. It will give us another trinket if we use it, which is okay, I guess. No one, either of those. I assume it doubles the effect of our trinket normally. We got two trinkets out of it because we have the car battery, which doubles the effectiveness of using a spacebar, right? Sweet. Deal with the Devil is pretty much crap. And we will go and fight Ultra Greed for the umpteenth time for no reason. My feet are cold. Trivia for you. Anyway, long story short, why is jealousy not a deadly sin? Why is it not as deadly as... Oh, you know why Sack Dagger's doing so well? It's because we've got BFFs, which doubles the damage of all of our familiars, including Orbitals. So... Oh, there you go. Damage there. I mean, we don't need to be using Sack Dagger to do any damage to this Joker right now. There's absolutely no reason to be doing what we're doing. In fact, our flies probably do enough damage. We didn't unfortunately manage to get Hive Mind. Let's use a Blue Babies on your friend. No, that's doing fuck all damage to it. Actually a bit of a wash. It would have been nice to get Hive Mind because then our guppy flies would be doing double damage instead of a 1.5. Double damage, but they do 1.5 times. Our tier's damage would have been doing 3 times. Our tier damage each. And we produce one every time a hit tier hits an enemy. This game is over. Thank you for watching. We will put some money in here for no reason. 6, 7, 8. So this was a fragile Judas run. Good game. GG. Thanks for watching. All just gem. Well, I guess I'm going to bed now. I'm so tired. Bye.